Hi, welcome to this video where I am going to film the strip down of this Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera, known as the original or the OG Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera. The reason I'm stripping this one down is to get to the micro HDMI port that needs replacing. You may have other reasons why you want to open it up or get to the circuit board, but it's a common fault that these HDMI ports break. So I'm gonna open it up to access this port and change the connector. I might disappoint you to say that I'm not going to film the actual replacing of the port. If you are going that far, I would say that you are already skilled enough to be replacing the port. So I'm not going to show you how. You should already know how. And if you are just going to try your luck and try and replace it yourself, I would advise you not to try, because you will very likely irreparably damage your camera. You should seek professional help to get that done, not do it yourself if you don't already have the skills for micro surface mount soldering. So sorry to disappoint you on that one, but that's my stance on it. But I will show you what one of the ports looks like so that you can see how small the connections are. And it should be a good illustration as to why you should not attempt to do this unless you really know what you're doing. So this is a port that has been replaced already. It's very, very small. It's not just the fact that the port's small. The real issue here is the actual connections on the ports. And you can see they are tiny, tiny, tiny. I don't know whether I'm doing it justice here to show you, but I'll show you a better image under a magnification. Hopefully you can see. Now you can see that those legs are all kind of soldered together, and that was to remove the port from the board. Heated up the all the legs by applying more solder and heating up. It heats up enough to remove them, but you can see the legs there, and there's two rows of legs, and they are tiny, so you need to be able to solder without bridging those legs across. Well, how they look right there, how they look, you don't want to be bridging them across like that. And I'll show you an image now of what they should look like once they're actually successfully applied to the board. And you'll see as well that the connector is quite burnt, because the amount of heat you have to apply to remove this standard port is quite high, and you do risk burning things, including the tracks on the board, because they're installed using lead-free solder, which has a much higher mounting point. And so it means that you have to get the connector very hot to get it off. And the fault with this one was not broken legs on the connector. The fault is actually the plastic center piece there that you can see. That actually has a crack in it, a very, very microscopic crack in it. And that meant that when a cable was plugged into that connector, if you very slightly flexed the cable in one way or another, the image would go away. To the point where if you just left the weight of the cable hanging on the port, the image would go away. But if you moved it into a certain position, the image would come back. So the port was dead from that point of view, or intermittent rather. And it wasn't that the solder joints had gone actually on the legs, but to fix the issue, we need to replace the port anyway. So I've actually already replaced the port on this camera. And what I'm actually going to do now is just strip it down again to show you how to get there. So let's set about that. And to start with, you need to access the screws to be able to undo it. And as you can see on the body, there's no screws anywhere. Even behind the battery flap there, there's no actual screws that make any sense to be undoing. But we're going to start by removing the battery. you may sort of try and search around looking in there for some kind of screw to undo, but forget that, it's not there that you need to look. All you actually need to do is peel away this rubber that's on the outside. So if you start here and peel away, and this is coming away easier for me because I've done it once before already, but it might be quite hard for you to peel away. But once you start to peel that away, you'll see screws begin to be exposed. So what you want to do is peel that all the way right back, and you will start to expose some screws up this end. There we go. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They are the screws that you need to remove. Don't try and take this off any further than that. You need to release the screws for the rest of this to actually come off. And this is held on, it's kind of sandwiched between this back panel and the metal body. So don't try and pull any further than that, but you need to peel it back enough to be able to access these screws. So we're gonna undo these screws. Keep your screws in a safe place, and what I would advise is to make yourself perhaps two little bags like I've done here, one labeled IS, one OS. IS is for the screws on the inside of the camera, and the OS is for the outside of the camera. So these six that I'm undoing now will go in the OS bag. So that's one. Two, 3, 4. Now, as you begin to undo the last ones, you kind of want to hold the camera together. You don't want the back just falling off, and I'll show you why in a moment. So the last one, while holding it together, there we go. Now, while still holding it together, the most important thing here is to not let the battery door fall off. It's actually, you can see here, it's on a spring so that it springs closed. And there's a pin that goes from the front panel to the back panel. And if you accidentally drop that pin and the spring, you know, it's going to fly off and go everywhere. So I advise you to hold the camera with the back facing you, and then hold the edge of the door, so the door there, hold it with a bit of pressure, holding it downwards to push the pin and hold it in its hole while you wiggle the back panel and raise it off, and it will probably just come out that much. There you go. And then you'll see exposed, there's two flexible ribbon PCB cables that will need to be released. But first, let's do the door. If you look very closely here, you'll see the spring is behind this piece of plastic. See the tang of the spring there? And it's behind that piece of plastic, and that's how the spring kind of holds its tension. So that's how you'll need to get it when reinstalling, and I'll show you that in the reinstallation video. Anyway, I'm going to lift that out, and be careful of the pin. You see it's already slipped down. Be careful you don't lose that pin. And put them to one side. And then we can come around to the side here, and where we've opened this up, we can just release the rubber cover that was being sandwiched between the front and the back. We can put that to one side. Try not to let any fluff and stuff collect on there, because the stickiness of it, if you keep it as sticky as it is right now, it will allow you to stick it back together quite easily. And then what we're going to do is go in and release these connectors here. So you can either get something like a small pry tool. I'm going to use this blade here. Be very careful if you're going to use a blade. Obviously, don't put it on these ribbon cables with the sharp side down. Don't lever against the ribbons at all. All that you want to do is literally with this first one here, I'm going to put the blade just under the edge of the black plastic here and flip up the release tab like that. You see that the tab there, move the camera sideways so you can see that that's flicked up. That little tab there is up. That was down and locked in place, but now it's up. You can just push the ribbon out and it's popped out. Now on this middle one, the black tab is on the opposite side. It's not on this side how the previous one was. It's on this side. And so you can just carefully release that one up and then push the cable out. You'll see the gold fingers of the ribbon cable there. That's the back panel off, and you can put that to one side. Now if you're opening it up to replace the screen, that's pretty much all you need to do, and you can undo these screws and then take the screen module out. So that's as far as you need to go if you're replacing the screen. And if you are like me wanting to get to the micro HDMI on this side here, we need to go a little bit further. And the next thing to do is to release this one. And with this one, again, it's on the same side as the ribbon. So this one in the middle here, the tab is on the far side. This one, it's on the same side as the ribbon, and so is this one. So you just flick it up to release it, and then you can just pull it out like so, and it's out. And then the next thing to do is have your inside screws bag handy, and we're going to undo 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws. So that was 6 on the outside and this 6 on the inside. So let's do that. Also make sure that you use a correct fitting screwdriver so that you're not rounding off the heads using a badly fitted screwdriver. Screws might be slightly tight and you don't want to push down hard and twist and then end up scratching the PCB and breaking tracks. So get a good fitting screwdriver, fits the screw very well, and when you undo it, the screw should literally stick to the end of the screwdriver because it's a correctly fitting driver. You shouldn't end up dropping things on the floor. Be very careful with your screwdriver and how much pressure you apply around all of these surface mount components, because if you accidentally slip and knock one of these components off, it could be game over for you. So the key is always slow and steady. It's not a race. Anyway, let's get the last one out. There we go. That's the 6 internal screws. Now, the board should be released from the mounting and you should be able to just raise it up. And what you're doing is bringing this whole battery compartment with you. So that's actually stuck onto the board. It's screwed down to the board. And what we're gonna do is just lift up from this end because this side is slightly jammed in place because of the outer frame here. So what we're going to end up doing is raising up and then bringing it out of these holes here. So let's do that little bit of a wiggle as we raise up that side. Little wiggle and raise it up and it'll come up, and there we go, we're up. Just be careful that this ribbon here and this ribbon here, they are not detachable. They're just compressed and folded over, and they're not detachable, so it's going to be a bit of a fiddle. And this one here is going to fall behind the board as we lift it out, but pull it towards the battery compartment. So you want to pull it in that direction, that way. Push it that way as you lift it, and it should release from that side. There we go. And just rotate and lift it up. And there we are. I'm going to zoom out just enough for you to be able to see. And we've lifted it out. At this point, you may wish to disconnect this one here. It's just two little tabs there you can pinch together and pull the cable at the same time. There we go. Gives you a bit more moving space. And then you will be working on the camera as it is like this. And we obviously now have access to our micro HDMI port. And as I said before, it's some very tiny soldering to mount this. So you have four points of contact for the body to solder onto the board and to actually anchor it. But that's the least of your worries. The real issue, if I can zoom in here, the real issue is these micro little legs here. You can see, hopefully you can see well enough, that that's where the real issue is. As I said, to remove the connector, you have to get things awfully hot, and you need to be really careful about these other plastic components around. And you know, just you can see here the connector here for the power thing got a bit hot and slightly melted, but not enough to be a problem. But that's as far as we're going to go for the disassembly. So that's opening it up and at least being able to work on your camera if you want to do something with it, replace a port like we have here. Stay tuned for the reassembly video. And if you like this video, the disassembly, please like the video, put a like on it, leave us a comment. And I'm sure people have something to say, and I welcome comments, any constructive, but you know what the internet's like. Anyway, I'm only posting this up to try and help people. I'm not trying to tell you how to do things in the sense of being some kind of authority on things. I'm just showing you how you would open up this camera. Anyway, hope you found it useful. Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for the reassembly, and good luck with your endeavors. Thanks. Bye.